Gamma-linolenic acid, Wikipedia audio. Gamma-linolenic acid or GLA, is a fatty acid found primarily in vegetable oils. When acting on GLA, arachidonate 5-lipoxygenase produces no leukotrienes and the conversion by the enzyme of arachidonic acid to leukotrienes is inhibited. GLA is categorized as an N6 fatty acid, meaning that the first double bond on the methyl end is the sixth bond. In physiological literature, GLA is designated as 18:3. GLA is a carboxylic acid with an 18 carbon chain and 3 cis double bonds. It is an isomer of alpha-linolenic acid, which is a polyunsaturated N3 fatty acid, found in rapeseed canola oil, soybeans, walnuts, flax seed, perilla, chia, and hemp seed. GLA was first isolated from the seed oil of evening primrose. This herbal plant was grown by Native Americans to treat swelling in the body. In the 17th century, it was introduced to Europe and became a popular folk remedy, earning the name King's Cure-All. In 1919, Hajduska and Luft extracted the oil from evening primrose seeds and described an unusual linolenic acid, which they named gamma-. Later, the exact chemical structure was characterized by Riley. Chemistry. Although there are alpha and gamma forms of linolenic acid, there is no beta form. One was once identified, but it turned out to be an artifact of the original analytical process. GLA is obtained from vegetable oils such as evening primrose oil, blackcurrant seed oil, borage seed oil, and hemp seed oil. GLA is also found in varying amounts in edible hemp seeds, oats, barley, and spirulina. Normal safflower oil does not contain GLA, but a genetically modified GLA safflower oil available in commercial quantities since 2011 contains 40% GLA. Borage oil contains 20% GLA, evening primrose oil ranges from 8% to 10% GLA, and black currant oil contains 15 to 20%. It also comprises 12.23% of the fats from the fruit of the durian species Durio gravolens. The human body produces GLA from linoleic acid. This reaction is catalyzed by delta-6, desaturase, an enzyme that allows the creation of a double bond on the sixth carbon counting from the carboxyl terminus. LA is consumed sufficiently in most diets, from such abundant sources as cooking oils and meats. However, a lack of GLA can occur when there is a reduction of the efficiency of the D6D conversion or in disease states wherein there is excessive consumption of GLA metabolites. From GLA, the body forms dehomogammalinolenic acid. This is one of the body's three sources of eicosanoids. DGLA is the precursor of the prostaglandin PGH1, which in turn forms PGE1 and the thromboxane TXA1. Both PGE11 and TXA1 are anti-inflammatory. Thromboxane TXA1, unlike its series 2 variant, induces vasodilation and inhibits platelet consequently. TXA1 modulates the pro-inflammatory properties of the thromboxane TXA2. PGE1 has a role in regulation of immune system function and is used as the medicine alprostadiol. Unlike AA and EPA, DGLA cannot yield leukotrienes. However, it can inhibit the formation of pro-inflammatory leukotrienes from AA. Although GLA is an N6 fatty acid, a type of acid that is, in general, pro-inflammatory, it has anti-inflammatory properties. GLA has been promoted as medication for a variety of ailments including breast pain and eczema, in particular by David Horobin, whose marketing of evening primrose oil was described by the BMJ as ethically dubious, the substance was likely to be remembered as a remedy for which there is no disease. In 2002, the UK's Medicines and Healthcare Products Regulatory Agency withdrew marketing authorizations for evening primrose oil as an eczema remedy. However, more recently, topical application of borage seed oil has been shown to reduce the symptoms of atopic dermatitis in a double-blind, placebo-controlled clinical trial. Another single source suggests that evening primrose oil with adjuvant vitamin E may reduce breast pain. History. Dietary sources. Source of eicosanoids. Health and Medicine. Notes and references.